this. Guaranteed turn a square to a positive. You ain't down, positive. I ain't got time for playing, I'm just saying. We out here trying to function, we out here trying to function. We out here trying to function, we out here trying to function. We out here trying to function, we out here trying to function. I ain't got time for playing, I'm just saying, man. We out here trying to function, we out here trying to function. We out here trying to function, we out here trying to function. We out here trying to function, we out here trying to function.
I'm the last of my kind. Get forever through these bars, everlasting my grind. If it ain't about money, then you're wasting my time. Mr. Molly with the liquor, now get out of your mind. Gotta do this one for the town, town business. I don't need with these clowns, a clown. In the city where the dealers go broke, they turn.
Skateboarding. For those of you who've been living in a cave for your whole entire life, skateboarding is an action sport which involves riding and performing tricks using a skateboard. Of course, over the last few years, skateboarding has become extremely popular. That's why I'm here, to see what that's about. To do this, I'll be hanging out with my cousin Kyle and his friend Cameron to see how life first gear is like. Also, I decided to try learning how to skateboard. Seeing as that is my first time ever to be on a board, it will be a challenge and I will get hurt. Definitely, definitely for sure get hurt. But before all of that, let's go through the history of skateboarding. Skateboarding first started in the 1950s. A bunch of California surfers got tired from surfing the water and decided to surf the streets. Yeah, like that was a very smart switchover.
This is what it looks like, the crash in surfing. As you can see, it looks beautiful, smooth, and no one gets hurt. And towards the end, he's happy and ready for some more. Now, let's take a look at skateboarding.
Now, this is when YOLO goes way too far. Thanks a lot for that, Drake. Anyway, let's get back to the present, where skateboarding has evolved from a sport to a lifestyle. Nowadays, we see the hip-hop industry filled with skateboarders, like this guy, and oh yeah, this guy.
Young Moolah, baby!
Now, let's forget about the stars and look at my cousin and his friend and their views on skateboarding.
I skate because, like, keeps me balanced as a person and it's pretty fun.
I skateboard because it's fun and it keeps me out of trouble.
I've been skateboarding for around a year and 2 months now.
Ah, man, if I weren't skating, probably be doing like bad stuff, doing drugs. Probably be doing bad stuff, doing drugs, shooting guys, you know. I think if I weren't skating, I'd be doing a lot of bad stuff. Or, I don't know, actually, I get influenced a lot, so I might have been doing bad stuff, so yeah.
I would probably, I don't know, just like sit home, play games, kind of be bored most of the time, but like skating's, it's quite a fun thing to do and it takes my mind off stuff.
I got into skateboarding because one of my family friends had a skateboard, and when I was like three, he used to skate a lot, and he always used to skate and then go to my house, and afterwards I was like, oh, that's so sick. And I used to play like video games, and then when I got to 10, I was like, man, I gotta do this because this is too good. And I started watching skate videos and I got so hyped into it, so I just started skating.
Like, it started with me playing a game called Skate 3. After Skate 3, like, I kind of got into skateboarding more and more, and then I decided, why not? Like, looks like a fun sport, looks quite cool.
Newcomers for skateboarding, I'll tell them that they should keep practicing.
Don't take it like too seriously, like don't say like as soon as I go into skateboarding I want to be like a pro or like anything along those lines. Just like have fun doing it and stick to it, and like one day you'll probably like get there.
Like keep doing your tricks, like every time like you try a trick, stick to it and don't give up and don't be lazy. This sport is not about being lazy. You cannot be lazy in this sport.
Skateboarding's good for you in a way that, like, it helps you stay fit, active.
I think it's a very good sport, you know. It's really annoying because security guards and police officers and a lot of people think it's a bad sport, but it's a really good sport.
Skate stoppers, like, it's kind of frustrating to, like, go out somewhere with all your homies and your bros and then like you find out, oh, this ledge is like skate stopped, or like this rail has like blockers on it.
They just like really annoying. They do it because they think that we're damaging their property, but we're not damaging any property, so we're just skating.
I guess like if it's private property then the places don't want you to destroy their like ledges, and they want their outdoors to look kind of nice and neat.
Life as a skater, it's annoying, you know. There's a lot of people, like, really, it's a lot of haters, you know, saying that you're called white boy.
Life as a skateboarder is kind of stressful at times, because, like, landing tricks, it can be difficult, and, like, paying for shoes, new boards, like, everybody knows that skateboarding is kind of an expensive sport, so it's kind of difficult, like, having the life of a skateboarder, but, like, just being on the board, like, kind of takes all that stress and everything away.
Bad things and good things. Wow, like you can get a lot of sprained ankles, you know, and like you can get hurt a lot.
I would say the bad things about skateboarding, as I mentioned before, is like landing tricks. It can be kind of frustrating and like get you angry most of the time.
Good things is like when you land a trick, you can get really happy and everyone loves you, and it's pretty cool.
The worst drop I ever had. It's when I first started skateboarding around one year ago, and then I was trying to ollie over a little gap, and then because I wasn't as good as I was now, then like I rolled my ankle in the process of trying to ollie over it, and took me off skating for a couple of weeks.
My worst drop. When I first started skating, I skated for 3 months, and then I tried to 180 south bank, and then afterwards I broke my leg because of a scooter kid. Yeah, you scooter kid, if you're watching this shit. Hey, if you're watching this, man, I want to sock you in the face.
Alright, I think we heard enough from these kids. Let's see how I did with learning how to skateboard. Alright, the first step for me for skateboarding was understanding my foot position, where I'd actually place my foot on the actual board. For me to know how to do that, I had to go up some stairs, and from that, my cousin will know if I'm a regular or a goofy.
So then, like, I walk up, left foot on the step first, and then right foot. First foot on the step is the foot you keep on the board, and then the other foot is the foot you push with. So yeah, pretty much. And for example, regular foot is take your left foot and it's on the board, and use your right foot to push off.
Yeah.
That's pretty much regular. Goofy, if you had stepped on the board with your right foot first, so you push off with your left foot and your right foot. Spread your feet out on the board, so then like you try and keep your balance.
Yeah,
like that. So when you're pushing naturally, like you just like keep one foot sideways. That's a word, for example. And then, so once you push off, your foot must be facing forward in front of you.
Yeah.
And your other foot is facing forward like that, parallel. Push off. And you just wanna rise. Keep both of your feet sideways, facing outwards. Yeah, like that.
Real soon afterwards, I got tired of hearing what my cousin had to say and decided to do some tricks on my own. As you can imagine, that didn't work out at all.
Go like this.
Pardon, baby. Skateboarding for so long that actual sport has rubbed off on me, that made me want to actually learn how to skateboard for myself. But after the footage you just saw, that was the only time I actually got taught how to skateboard. That's mainly because I never had enough time to go out skateboard for myself. So if you want to become a skateboarder, you need dedication and passion, and maybe one day you find yourself skateboarding in front of millions of people.
Like, I understand. understand that, like, some people.
Skateboard because it's fun and it keeps me out of trouble. There's a lot of gangs around my area. Ah, man, it's so much trouble, you know.